Hello, this is Chris Beasley, and in this video, we're going to show you the power of the EIS Autofit routine. Now, the Autofit routine is a feature in Gamry's EIS software that allows you to take the guesswork out of estimating initial parameter values in your model. The data that you see here are data for or potentially static EIS data for an 18650 lithium-ion battery. The data were collected using 2 millivolts RMS at a DC offset of 4.2 volts. The data were collected from 10 kilohertz down to 100 microhertz. The model that we will be fitting is the model that you see here. We have essentially two RC elements and two transmission line elements and a CPE element. All told, we have 19 parameters for fitting. So when I go to fit the model, I'm going to click on impedance, click fit a model, select my model, and then you're going to see all 19 parameters listed here. So we're going to lock the two length elements into transmission line models. And so this gives us 17 free parameters that we're going to fit. I click on the auto fit, and you'll see a note here. It says auto fitting impedance data. This may take up to 5 minutes. Since we have this many parameters in our model, this is going to take a little bit of time. So during this time, I'm actually going to speed the video up. And there you have it. So you'll notice that the timestamp in the upper right corner is sped up in this video during the auto fitting. So I also want to make a note for those of you that did notice it. In the window that popped up, you'll notice that there was a not responding put on that message box. And that's simply because Ecamm Analyst is a single-threaded application. And in Windows, if a single-threaded application does not respond after some period of time, Windows likes to throw that message. Nothing to worry about. Okay, so let's continue on here. We can see that the AutoFit routine did a pretty good job fitting. This high-frequency region up here is not really of concern for a lithium-ion battery. But let me show you what you would do next. At this point, I would unlock the two length elements. If you wanted to, you can still leave them as one. And then I would calculate a little bit further. And you can see the fit is slowly getting a little bit more optimized in certain places. More importantly, we're interested in this region down here. And we can see that we have quite a good fit now at this point. So I'm going to click close. And you can see we've added a tab to this end of the thing. It shows parameter values and errors associated with those values.